This image was shot on Delta 100 and was developed with a 4-year-old developer. And this image was taken on the same camera with the same film stock, just moments apart, but was developed with fresh chemistry. Can you spot any differences? I wanted to make this video not in order to convince you that developers don't wear out, but to talk about the importance of storage conditions and best practices. I use this as an excuse to test out both my new RZ67 and my old Ilfotec HC. I grabbed two rolls of Delta 100 and loaded them into two separate bags in order to shoot the same subjects back to back with the same setup. I planned this shoot of the pasta dough making process and made all images using a piece of marble as my background. I used a single strobe light with a reflector and a grid attached and placed it behind a large sheet of diffusion. I also used a white card to give me some fill light on the shadow areas. After finishing the two rolls, I developed one with my 4-year-old Ilfotec HC, which I first used on May 2021 and for one reason or another never got to finish the whole bottle. And developed the second roll with a fresh, unopened bottle of Ilfotec HC, which I bought a few days ago. I used the same development recipe for both rolls, and apart from a different developer, they were identically processed. Subject to any slight variations, of course, since I manually develop the films. Things like agitation or accurate measuring of the concentrate can never be 100% identical. So let's have a look at the negatives first and see if we can find any differences. Here are the scans of the negatives before the inversion. The image on the left is the one processed on the 4-year-old developer, and the one on the right is with the fresh one. On the first look, I would say that the one processed in the expired chemistry looks a hair more contrasty, which isn't really an indication of developer aging, but I'll get to that in a minute. As far as grain goes and overall look of the negatives, I can't say there are any other differences. I went ahead and inverted the negatives using Negative Lab Pro, using Cinematic Flat as my profile, and leaving all the sliders zeroed. I added the same amount of sharpness in Photoshop and saved the files. So here is our final example. The expired developer is once again on the left side, and on your right is a fresh one. What we saw on the negative is confirmed on the inverted image. The one I developed with expired chemistry has a tad more contrast. The shadow areas look slightly darker and the bright areas look just a hair brighter on my monitor, though I'm not sure if you will be able to see that with the YouTube compression. Now, I'm happy that it came out this way, with the expired one being a bit more contrasty, because if it was the other way around, I might have been fooled into thinking that the developer is degrading. You see, if the developer had lost its strength, it would lead to an underdeveloped image. It would either need more time to develop it fully, or it wouldn't be able to develop it at all. Since the test was done manually, it is expected that a slightly weaker or vigorous agitation can lead to a different level of contrast. Same goes for the dilution of the developer and the measurements. I am using a syringe to measure the developer, but these syrupy liquids like Ilfotec HC or Rodinal require very small amounts of the concentrate. Thus, even the slightest variation can produce a measurable difference. If you have to measure 100 ml of something and you are off by 1 ml, it might not be a big of a deal. But when measuring, say, 18 ml, then just one off will cause a visible difference to the developed negative. For the rest of the images, and to have a look at all the technical information on how I did this test, I have written a detailed blog post with all the relevant information and side-by-side examples. To conclude this video, I piled up a few tips that will help you preserve your developer for longer, plus examples on how to test your chemistry to assess its condition. So, tip number one. Oxygen is your chemistry's enemy. And so is light. After opening your fresh bottle, try to decant it to either one of these opaque squeeze bottles that allow you to compress them before putting the lid on, or use a few of these amber glass bottles, filling them to the top. That way you will keep all the air out, ensuring that your developer will not oxidize as quickly. The more room there is at the top of your bottle, the faster your chemical will oxidize. Number 2. Keep your bottles in a dark and cool environment. It doesn't need to be in the fridge, room temperature is fine, but aim for something between 10 to 20 degrees Celsius, as most manufacturers recommend. Don't stress if your room reaches 22 or 25, but if it's consistently hotter, then I would suggest you try to find a part of your house that doesn't get that hot or sunny. Number 3. Always read the manufacturer's datasheet. Not every chemical is the same, so take your time to read the manufacturer's guidance. Generally speaking, thick syrupy developers will hold for much longer. They are very concentrated, thus more robust and less prone to oxidation. You will always find that one guy in the forums who is still using that bottle of Rodinal he bought 20 years ago. Number 4. Don't be afraid to test your chemistry. and don't just chuck it out for a new one just in case. Whether from an economy or environmental perspective, there is no need to just assume it has gone bad. Testing is easy and will require just a bit of your time. An easy way to test your developer would be to cut a small piece of film in the dark and proceed to develop it as normal. The part of the leader should develop as pitch black since it is exposed to light. The rest of the film should be completely clear apart from the markings. The markings that you see at the top and bottom of the sprockets of your film are pre-exposed at the factory and they should develop as deep black if the film is fresh. Don't use expired films to test your developer, as the markings might look faded or have completely disappeared, as the latent image doesn't last forever on the negatives. Of course, you can also shoot a test roll, or just a few frames and cut them in the dark if you want an even better example. If you are looking to test your fixer, then that's pretty easy to do. Cut the leader from a fresh film, I'm using HP5 in this example, put it in a small beaker and pour in some of your working solution. You should see the film turning clear in the first couple of minutes, thus indicating your fixer is still fine. Last but not least, tip number 5. If you're processing any paid work or anything that is very important to you, then always make sure your chemistry is flawless. And if it's not, then get some fresh chemicals. The last thing you want to do is mess up a job or an important personal project. Always read the manual and then research some more. These are just some tips. Don't take them as gospel. As always, you will find all relevant links in the description box of the video and feel free to continue the discussion in the comments below, adding any tips or personal experiences. And let me know, did you ever have to throw away a developer feeling unsure about its condition? I'm keen to read how you dealt with it. Thank you for watching and see you next time.